What is going on, everybody? Ordinary Randy here, and today we're going to be reviewing the Sanyun SW208 speaker off of Amazon. I already unboxed it. I've been using it. It's right here, and we'll do some testing on it. Now, I bought these for about $60. It was on a discount. I think normally it's $80, $90. I'll have it up on the screen right here. Definitely on a discount, good price for the discount. I got the 3-inch version, which I didn't realize 3 inches was the actual speaker part, not the whole white piece that you see right there. That's not 3 inches. This whole thing's like maybe 5-6, I'm not sure, but this little circle part is 3 inches. That's what it meant. So in the box, obviously it comes with the speakers and comes with this little pamphlet right here. It's got some information on how to use it if you don't know what you're doing, but I'll explain how to use it and some different options on it. Also comes with this cable. It's a USB something. I forgot. I don't know what this is called. And then to a micro USB, what you would use on an old Android charger. Also an audio jack, 3.5 millimeters, I think. That's what I have connected right now. I'll show you how I have it connected and what all you can do with it too. Okay, so right now I have them plugged in with an audio jack, 3.5 millimeters. And you see that light is green, that is for the audio jack. So there is the left out to connect to the other speaker on the other side. Then there is the aux in, that's for the millimeter. There's a USB, the micro USB for that came in the box. There's also a power button right here and the output right there connects into the wall. All right, so you have the volume control / mode. Then you also have treble and bass. You can change that as it is. I've been toying around with the bass. So as you can see right now, since it is green, I'm just gonna put a little. Okay, it's coming out and it's connected to my monitor. So I don't have an extra output. But if I go back and I press and hold, now it's red, that is gonna put an audio output if I connect it via the micro USB and a USB to the computer. But you can see no sound because it's not connected through micro USB. And if I change it to Bluetooth, now it's blue, it's looking, and now that it's stopped blinking, it's paired. You can see right here, SW208. That is very loud. But I prefer audio jack connectivity because of that. It keeps disconnecting and connecting. And I don't want to fumble around with that. That's too much. So, press and hold to change. And now that it's green, it is connected through the millimeter jack. And it's easier controlled. So I have this maxed out. I got this maxed out as well. And I got this maxed out. And it's still a little quiet, but all you need to do is through your monitor, turn it up. And for this monitor right there, that button, if I just move it to the right, that's how you change the volume. If I just move it this way like that, change the volume from there. And if you notice, turn it up. Sound test. Pretty loud. So for size comparison, I have a Mountain Dew, a 12 ounce Mountain Dew. We'll set that next to it. So it's about 1.5 Mountain Dews, I'd say. Maybe 1 1/3, roughly. Yeah. But you can see the speaker, this part, is roughly 3 inches. And I thought the whole speaker would be this big. But turns out it's bigger than that. Here's my hand compared to the speaker. Here is a pacifier also compared to the speaker. Now, I've seen this, and when I play sounds and everything, or play music, do whatever, it doesn't do anything. I don't know what that's for. It's empty in the back. So it's empty in the back right there.
I don't know what it does, because it doesn't vibrate or do anything when I'm playing sound or music out of it.
So before I do a sound test with some music, should be protected under fair use. I'm making a video around it. I'm using a couple seconds of a song just so that I can show the quality of the sound of these speakers. I'm not copyright infringing. I'm not trying to steal the music. I'm only playing snippets.
For the first sound test, we'll use Umbrella. Next, we'll do a song that has good bass. I'll leave it at the bass stats, and then I'll turn up the dial on the bass. The bottom will turn up the bass. So now we have the bass turned up all the way. And lastly, 5% to. And this is with the bass up. I'll turn the bass down. That's normal. That's normal bass. And then we'll turn it all the way down. No bass. We'll turn up treble. Then we can turn up the bass again. This is both bass and treble, all the way at max.
Now, through my testing and use of these speakers on an everyday basis, using it for Call of Duty, playing games, listening to music. One, I really enjoy listening to music on it. It's made me listen to music a little more at the house. I usually don't. Two, when I play Call of Duty, it does seem a little bassy, like the guns. When you shoot, you feel and hear a lot of bass. You can always just turn that down with the settings. It's not hard at all. But if you like that, turn it up. I do like bass myself, but when it comes to Call of Duty and playing games, I don't really like a lot of that bass. I feel like it takes away from everything else going on. I feel like it's taken away from the rest of the sounds, but that's just me. That's my personal opinion. So when I first got the speakers, I was really excited that they were Bluetooth and I didn't have to use wires. I was like, oh, less wires. But I decided against that and started using the audio jack, because if I used Bluetooth and I only connected it to my PC, then if I got on my PS4, I have to switch it and look for the PS4 and connect it to the PS4 and keep doing that. But I found it easier to use the audio jack, the 3.5 millimeter, and I won't have to switch it at all. It's just connected to the monitor regardless. It connects to the monitor and the speaker, so I don't have to switch anything. One thing I will say is when I connected it with the audio jack to the monitor from the speakers, it made a staticky sound. It was static for a little bit. It just went maybe 10-15 seconds, and then it just went away. So I don't know what that was about. It was also like a, when you connect a bass guitar or something to like a big amp, you hear that's the sound it made. But after that, it just wasn't, it stopped doing it. So after it was all the way plugged in, I haven't tried it with the micro USB to USB yet. I think it's type A, USB type A. I haven't tried that yet, and I don't know if I will use it. I'll keep it in case, but overall, good speakers, in my opinion, good quality for what you're paying. I'm not an audio expert, so all I know is that it sounds good. It sounds good to my ears, and I haven't had speakers before for any type of setup, and I have, but they were like really shitty ones back in the early 2000s, maybe 2010s. For the price you're paying, these are some good quality speakers. If you don't mind adding a cable or two to your setup, if you don't have speakers, if you do have speakers, you're not really changing much, I think. You'll just have the power connector to the wall and the audio jack or the USB, whichever you prefer. And if you want to go completely wireless and you just have one thing to connect it to, use Bluetooth. Overall, good speaker. I enjoy it. I'd rate it a solid, I'd give it an 8 out of 10. It's good quality. I think the only thing missing is reputability and being well known as a brand. Sanyun, I've never heard of, and it's my first time buying something from them. I don't know if they're well known anywhere. I've never heard of them myself. So to me, they're unknown. So I was taking a risk buying these. That they definitely are missing reputability for what they have. Solid 8 out of 10. I'd give it a 10 out of 10, but the base during gameplay, that's kind of killing it for me. Obviously, it's easily changeable, but I think, like, at its baseline stats, it shouldn't be too heavy with it. But it is good for music. I enjoy it for music. When it comes to music, the bass isn't as strong as I would like as it is in the games. In the games, the bass is strong, but when it comes to music, I like feeling the bass, like in my Crusher wireless headphones. This bass isn't bass you feel, it's bass you hear. And I think that it's just missing the mark on where you hear the bass and in what circumstances. But these are really good for the price you're paying, about 50, 60 bucks on Amazon. I'll link that down below in the description. Leave a comment down below if I missed some things, if there's some things I didn't go into that you would have liked me to go into, if I could have gone more in depth in some areas not so much. So let me know how the review was, and if you would like to learn more or know a little more for future reviews. I do have some things coming in that I'm going to be reviewing as well. Another audio thing, headphones. So look out for that. I'll have it right here or here, wherever I put it. I don't know. But if you enjoyed the video, leave a like, comment down below. If you didn't enjoy the video, leave a dislike and comment down below. Which thing I could do to improve. Other than that, have a great day.